whenever we have any risk, just to handle the risk, we have a risk management. And when we talk about the risk management, what they do, they create a risk management plan. Management plan. What they will mention in the risk management plan. Yes, Michelle.
The potential risks.
Potential risk, okay. What else?
Whatever is known or unknown.
But we are not going to mention the EEF inside the risk management plan.
Okay.
Because of those factors, you can have risk. You can have some uncertainties. Right. So here, what we will do, you will mention like how you will handle against those risks. So here, what is the thing here? First is, as we are talking about the risk, you have to take some kind of risk. Without risk, we can't run the project. First thing, you have to take kind of risk. As I am talking about some kind of risk, it can be small or
large
risk. It depends. So here, it can be smaller or large risk. We will define the risk attitude. Risk attitude. And as we are talking about the risk attitude, you should define also like how you will handle the risk, or what is your willingness to handle the risk. So there is a risk appetite. What is risk appetite? Risk appetite. What is risk appetite?
It's just how you handle.
Ready to take a risk. How much risk you can bear.
The level ready of to, how you're ready to take a risk.
Ready to take a risk. Next is risk tolerance. What is risk tolerance?
Whether you're capable, you can take the risk.
Can you give me an example? Any generic example?
I have a piece of equipment that's coming into the building, and the seismic activity that comes off of the piece of equipment could be a challenge. And so will the project as a whole be able to tolerate that risk? I don't know.
Okay, let's make it more simple.
Okay.
whenever we talk about the risk, best practice says you should involve the financial management also. Should involve why? Well, why we need to involve the financial management?
But they need to understand that there could be more financial obligation should we take this supposed risk. So they understand to have contingency available in the budget.
So here, what we do, we define the risk budget. So in the risk budget, obviously, you will mention some funds. So as I'm talking about here, risk appetite, and I'm saying ready to take a risk. How much risk you can bear? How much? So let me just put $100. Fill the $100. Now, you can have some exceptions as well. beyond the risk, beyond the risk, which means here, let me put $40. Is my dollar, yeah. $40. So which means, what is my risk threshold? Risk threshold?
$60.
Threshold. That means total risk capacity. 100 plus 40.
$140.
Oh, okay. So the first thing, what we will try to do, first, I will try to use my only risk appetite. But somehow, if I will not handle the risk with this amount, so I will approach to this tolerance amount. Mm-hmm. But might be possible that risk go beyond that, as like total risk threshold is $140. If it is going beyond that, then what you will do, either you will try to do some modifications, try to do some changes, or you will stop the project. Because if, as per your planning, if risk is going beyond that, obviously I don't want to face any losses, more losses, right? So here you will define the risk threshold. And as we are talking about the risk, so what you will do, you will identify the risk as well. So here, first is risk management plan. Next process is identify risk. Let me show you something here. We are discussing about this. Plan risk management, then identify risk, qualitative, quantitative, and create the plans. And after the plan, we'll implement these risk responses. You can say risk response, or you can say risk plans as well. So here, as we are talking about risk appetite, risk threshold, so you need to find out the risk as well. If you are unable to find out the risk, how like you will use all these things? So when you are able to find out the risk, where you will put this information? Here, we create risk register. Risk register, or we create risk reports. So basically, they are the formats. So when we are talking about the risk here, risk management plan, like the it is so slow. Inside the risk, you will define all these things. So here, when we identify the risk, so what you will do here, you will use what document, which is risk register. You will use risk register here, and what you will mention, what you will do? Potential risk. Potential risk. Or you can say you will create a list, basically. Any questions so far? Hello?
I'm looking at it.
Okay.
So in order to take the risk management plan, in order to identify the risk management plan, you need to take the pulse basically the risk attitude, the appetite, the tolerance, the threshold. And you do that by developing a risk register and ultimately a report that goes into the identified risk.
Yeah.
And what's potential risk list? I mean,
potential risk is something like what
I risk understand, you... I understand what it means, but how does it come into play after identify risk?
Okay, we will discuss like more about the identify risk so you will get the answer.
Okay.
Just give me five more minutes because we are going to discuss one more topic related to the risk management here. So you will get the idea.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome. Now, here, what we are going to do, there is a process, step-by-step process. First is, let's pick one scenario here. Scenario is something like you have malware in your laptop. Then what you will do?
Go to the Geek Squad and have them fix it.
Fix it. Okay. Perfect. What else?
Be panicky and scared that something happened and lose my bank account.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What else?
I don't know.
Okay.
But the geeks are taking care of it.
So here, first thing, identify.
Oh, whenever, yeah.
Whenever we have any risk during the project, obviously you will take the action against that, corrective action. You will implement some plans also. But first, we need to understand what is the source of the risk. Source. Or you can say cause of the risk. From where you get it. Right. Maybe like you are using flash drive. Maybe you are using external hard disk. Maybe you clicked on some links. It could be anything. First, we need to understand what is the source of the risk. Right?
Yep.
After that, next is area. Where it is affecting. Like in your laptop, you have C drive, D drive, E drive. Suppose it is affecting on D drive, right? And in D drive, suppose you have 100 folders. Here we are checking the impact also. What is the impact of it? Maybe like because of that malware, from 100 folders, 70 folders are converted into exe file. Or maybe they are hidden, they have deleted. It could be any impact, right? So whenever we have any risk, so what we do, we are doing identification of the risk, and after that, what you will do, where you will put this information, risk register. So here, when we are talking about, did you get the answer or not?
I get the yes.
Potential risk, right? So here, as I mentioned, list or like, list related to all the risks. So here, and what we'll do, first we do identification, and where we have decided this format in the plan, risk management plan. So when you identify the risk, you will put this information in the risk register. Okay. After that, identify the risk, after that, what you will do? What will be the next step? What will be the next
after you identify the risk, after you identify the potential risks?
Yeah, after that, what?
Well, maybe create a report.
Directly, you will create the report. Okay. You do assessment.
Oh.
So here, what we are going to do? Estimate and evaluate. Can you differentiate it? What is the difference between them?
Estimate is just figuring it out, just having it's a rough idea. Evaluate is taking the risks and looking through them and understanding them, like evaluating them to see the impact.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So
as sense. You mentioned, first let me mention this point here. As you mentioned, risk impact. So here, what we do, we are checking the probability and impact.
Probability
into impact. So what do you understand about this probability into impact?
I would think that would be under evaluate, but you're gauging the risk.
Mm-hmm.
And identifying it like in a measurement, like a scale. Is it a high probability that it's gonna be an issue or a low probability? You identify the impact by, you know, like yay or nay. You know what how much of it's gonna be a risk.
Yeah. So here, let's come back here. As first, we discuss about. We create this risk management plan. This is one of the process here.
Yeah.
Risk management.
Yeah.
Plan. Next is we do identification. Yeah. And here we are going to do risk prioritizations as well.
Risk prioritization.
So here we have qualitative. So here, what we are going to do? Prioritization. And when we do risk prioritization, so here, we have come to probability into impact. Here in the qualitative risk analysis, what we do, we are measuring the risk like low risk, medium risk, high risk. So the thing is here, when we doing this calculation, probability and impact, let me show you one more example so you will have more clear picture about this. Just have a look at this image. Here we have different scenarios. In the first scenario, there is a bicycle and there is a lady. And risk is about the accident, right? So here, there is a one bicycle in every 5 minutes. So you can say likelihood, you can say probability. So what is the probability of an accident? Very low, right? Hello, yeah. Right? Yeah. And if somehow you will face or that lady will face an accident, what will be the impact or you can say consequences? Very low, because this is a bicycle. It will not hurt her a lot. In the next scenario, you have number of bicycles. So what is the probability of an accident?
High,
but impact will be
low.
In the third scenario, what is here? You have truck. So again, scenario is same as like bicycle. You have one truck in every 5 minutes. So what is the probability of an accident? Very low.
Hello.
You can say very low or you can say low. But if somehow you will face an accident, so what will be the impact here?
High.
Right? In the fourth scenario, very frequently, like number of trucks are here. So probability of an accident will increase and effect will be high also. So risk factor is very high in this scenario, right? So here, what we are going to do, we are going to do risk scoring also. Risk scoring, let me just mention here. We are going to do risk So how we will do risk scoring? We are checking, like just assume the probability of an accident is like, just assume 0.8. Just assumption, these are the assumptions. Impact is like, as we were talking about this bicycle, so impact will be very low, not high. Not high. So here, what will be the risk scoring? You will do multiplication and risk scoring is 0.16. So here we will define the limits also. How we will define the limits? You will decide it is low, medium, and high. In some organizations, we are using very low, very medium, high, very high, like this way. But like this is the standard, and most of the organizations are using only this low, medium, and high. So here, as per the scenario, as per the project, we will define the range also. So range is like this is zero. I'm defining the range here. This is like 0.2 and high will be 0.6 or something else. So you can give the ratings here accordingly. So when you will calculate this risk scoring, so you will check your table there, whatever you have decided. So you can easily consider this is the low or this is the medium or this is the high risk. Is it clear now? So what you will do, if risk is high, suppose let's assume if risk is high here, risk is high, so what you will do, you will try to more focus to the high risk because this is an urgency. This is a urgency, but doesn't mean you will ignore the low risk. No. So here what we will do, we will create a watch list. Create a watch list. What is watch list here?
Similar to backlog?
Yeah, kind of, you can say. But backlog, which is something, the requirement you have there.
Yeah.
This is not the requirement.
You have to understand that you laughed, so you know I'm getting some information in.
We create the watch list, right? So here, third is, if we come to the processes, next is what? Next is qualitative. So in the qualitative, you are telling like low, medium, and high. Now, any questions so far? Hello, Michelle, no. Any questions so far?
No.
Okay. And during evaluation, we will evaluate the resources here. So, like, how much resources will impact and cost, time, and then quality and risk appetite. Now, once assess will done, what will be the next step? What is the next process? What you will do? You will create the plan.
The plan. Okay.
Plan. Already we have discussed about this prioritize. Here, okay. At the time of qualitative, where we discussed this probability and impact. Because as here, what you are doing prioritization. Based on the prioritization, you are checking the probability and the impact of the risk here. So this is what qualitative. Now next is. Is it next is this identify risk. Perform qualitative risk is quantitative risk. So when we talk about the quantitative risk analysis, next is, any idea what is quantitative risk analysis?
No.
Okay, no problem. Quantitative. So these are risks which have high impact on or probability on the project objectives. So here basically we are doing mathematical and simulation, using mathematical and simulation tool to calculate the probability and impact. So in quantitative, we are using numbers. Basically we do this quantitative in numbers. And we do quantitative risk analysis for the long-term perspective, not for the short-term. And next step, what we will do? You will create a plan risk response. So here, you will create a plan. You can say plan, you can say risk response. So when we are going to, and this is an ongoing process. So when we come to this plan and risk response, it can be positive or it can be negative. It can be positive or it can be negative. Negative or it can be positive, or you can say it is threat and this is opportunity. Opportunity.
Opportunity. Okay.
Yeah. Here.
Okay. Yeah.
We are going to make the plans. So, first plan based on like this risk register, and we will update the risk register throughout these steps. So based on this risk register, like based on the source, based on the probability and impact, based on these resource cost time, we are going to make some plans here. So what we can do in some organization, I don't know you have an idea or not, in few organizations, they are not allowing to carry flash drives, external hard disk. They do not allow. You can't bring all these things in the office. This is a very good thing. So you can like first aid simple, avoid it, don't use it, but sometimes we can't avoid, we don't have other options. So next we can focus to the reduce. So how you can reduce the impact of the risk? Yes, how, Michelle?
How do you reduce the impact of the risk?
Yeah. Impact and probability of the risk.
I don't get it. Sorry.
Okay. I'm saying, like, as we are aware through this identification of the risk, we have risk because of the flash drive. You use the flash drive, and through the flash drive, you have malware. You have some viruses in your laptop, right? So here we check the probability and impact of that risk with the help of risk scoring, right?
Yeah.
And we have decided about the cost, time, quality, risk appetite also there. So based on these factors, we are going to create a plan how we can handle that risk. How? Either you can avoid the flash drive, don't use it. As in some organization, as I mentioned, you can't carry flash drives or external hard disk in the organization. Simple, avoid it. Next is reduce. Because like we can't avoid it because of any reason. So how you can reduce the impact of the risk and how you can reduce the probability of the risk. You can make some policies there. Like what policies? Just disable the flash drive port. So if you want something, so go to the IT department. IT department will copy in the registry or repository, and from there you can easily retrieve the data. So reduce it.